Today's video is about finding the area of rectilinear shapes. Let's find the area of this triangle ABC in the figure. We already know that the area of a triangle can be found by simply taking half of the product of the base and height. In this figure, BC can be easily identified as the base of the triangle, while the height of this triangle is the perpendicular distance of point A from side BC. By simply counting, the number of horizontal units of the base BC is 6 units, and the vertical height of the triangle is also 6 units. Therefore, the area of this triangle is 1/2 × 6 × 6, which is equal to 18 square units. We can also use the distance formula in finding this triangle's area. If you can recall, the distance formula between two points is the square root of x2 minus x1 bracket squared, plus y1 minus y2 bracket squared. Given that the coordinates of vertices C, B, and A are 1, minus 2, minus 5, minus 2, and minus 2, 4 respectively, and the midpoint of BC is minus 2, minus 2, by substituting x and y values into the distance formula, the distance between point B and point C is 6 units, and the height is 6 units. Therefore, the area of this triangle is 1/2 × 6 × 6, which is equal to 18 square units, exactly the same area value we got when we used the counting method. There are cases when the base of the given triangle is not parallel to the x-axis and its height is not parallel to the y-axis. This makes the counting method of horizontal units and vertical units difficult to be used. Therefore, the distance formula must be applied. Angle is 22.5 square units. Another method that can be used in finding the area of triangle ABC is using what is called the box method. This method is to simply enclose the given shape inside a box or a rectangle that touches all the vertices of the shape. By getting the areas of the smaller parts, usually in the shape of smaller triangles, they can then be subtracted from the enclosing box or rectangle. Thus, giving the area of the shaded region, which is the given shape, the area of the enclosing rectangle is 49 square units, while the area 1 is 7 square units, area 2 is 25 over 2 square units, and area 3, which is just the same as area 1, is also 7 square units. Now, the area of the triangle is 49 subtracted by 53 over 2, which is 22.5 square units. This area is the same area answer that we got when we used the distance formula. Knowing how to use this method may also be beneficial. But, this method can also be limited when there are too many smaller sub-areas to find. Another alternative method that can be used in finding the area of polygons on a Cartesian plane, regardless of its shape, is what is called the shoestring or shoelace method. This method utilizes the coordinates of the polygon and arranging them in a matrix form. So, if a polygon has some n vertices, we can arrange the coordinates in columns by writing the y-coordinates below the x-coordinates, like in vectors, starting with any vertex followed by the next vertex counterclockwise until back to first vertex. Take note that first column coordinates must be the same with the last column coordinates. We then multiply the vertices diagonally downwards and then taking their sum. And then, do the same diagonally upwards, and taking their sum. Area of the shape then is 1/2 of the absolute value of the downward sum subtracted by the upward sum. Follow the working on the same triangle we used a while ago, but this time applying the shoelace method. Just pause the video. Compare the shoelace method with the methods used a while ago. They should give the same area of the triangle. Apply your knowledge on finding the area of this polygon using the shoelace method. Pause this video at this moment to give yourself some time.